the latest in our ITV Fixers series. And with the Christmas party season well underway now, a warning about making sure your drink isn't being spiked behind your back. It's becoming increasingly common.
Now young people are doing something about it. In a moment, how you can take part. But first, how a group of young women from the YWCA are fixing things in Bristol.
I'm Lauren Eves, I'm 19 and I'm a resident here at the Mother and Baby Unit in Bristol. My son is called Corey, he's 5 months old. He's a big, big baby. Our ITV Fixers campaign is all about drink spiking and how to be more aware of it and telling people the statistics of people not reporting and how many people do report and like their age ranges and that it can happen to anybody.
Me and my friend went into a pub. We both bought a drink. That was the last thing I can remember until I was in hospital. We both got fined on like opposite sides of Bristol. When she got fined, her handbag had gone missing and her jewellery was all gone as well. And she had like bruises on the inside of her legs, so they thought she might have been raped. But she wouldn't let none of the nurses do any tests on her to find out if she was or not. I think she got spiked with the same thing as what I do. I felt like really scared.
Like I only went out to have a drink with my mate and I didn't realise like
we was both going to end up in hospital. No one was ever caught for it.
The majority of drink spiking instances that we get are not drug related. They tend to be alcohol related, so spiking of alcohol with more alcohol. For actual drug spiking of drinks, we expect to see some. It wouldn't be a huge number, but we certainly would expect to see perhaps a couple a week.
Drink spiking has risen by 160% since the introduction of the smoking ban. Why do you think that is?
I think it's because when you're in a club, you can't take your drinks outside with you when you have a cigarette, so they like you have to leave them on a table so people can easily do it then.
ITV Fixers have provided posters and coasters to put up around clubs and pubs in Bristol to make people more aware of what does go on and that it can happen to anybody. The advert as well, which was quite hard hitting.
It makes you think more about who you can trust, because even your close friends, you might leave your drink with them and they might turn their head for just a second, and that's enough time for anyone to spike your drink.
I think there is a general underreporting through either embarrassment because something has happened that night which they don't want anyone to know, or due to the fact that they physically can't remember because the drug that's been used is something that does cause them to lose their memory.
Hiya, we've got some posters to put up about drink spiking.
Yeah, that's fine, just put them anywhere. We'd like the percentage of people having their drink spike to go down, and we want people to know that it does happen. And we want people who are doing it to stop. It's stupid. I mean, whether it's intentional or you're just doing it for a joke, you could kill someone.
And if you feel strongly about drink spiking and would like some of the posters and coasters for your local pub or club, then call the number on screen now, 01793 680 030. Or, of course, you can visit our website, which is at itvlocal.com/ITVFixers.